Good morning, children. In last class, in geography lesson, we are discussing about water and photosynthesis and air and photosynthesis. In water and photosynthesis, von Helmont found that water is essential for increasing plant mass. Mass means weight. And air and photosynthesis. Joseph Priestley conducted a series of experiments in 1770 by his experiments. While conducting the experiments, he discovered oxygen in 1774. Who discovered the oxygen? Joseph Priestley. In which year? In 1774. Later, the name oxygen was coined by Levasseur in 1775. Who coined the name oxygen? Levasseur. In which year? In 1775. So today we are going to the topic factors. So already we know to perform photosynthesis by the plants, they need some factors. What are the factors required by the plants to perform photosynthesis? Carbon dioxide, water, sunlight, and chlorophyll. These are the factors required by the plants to perform photosynthesis. If any one of these factors are absent or not available to the plants, no photosynthesis takes place and no starch is prepared in the plants. Okay, first we have to conduct an experiment to prove that carbon dioxide is essential for photosynthesis. Let us discuss about that activity. Okay. What is the aim of our activity? To prove that carbon dioxide CO2 is essential for photosynthesis. This is the aim of this activity. So, to conduct this activity, we need some apparatus. Okay. What are the apparatus we need to conduct this activity? Potted plant. Wide-mouthed glass bottle. KOH solution, potassium hydroxide. Iodine solution. Split cork. These are the apparatus we need to conduct this activity. Let us discuss about the procedure. Okay. First, select a potted plant with a long and narrow leaves. Keep it in a dark place for nearly 1 week. Why we kept the plant in dark place for nearly 1 week? To remove the starch from leaves. Already prepared starch is present in the leaves. To remove the prepared starch, plant kept in dark place for nearly 1 week. On the day of experiment, take a wide-mouthed glass bottle and take 5 to 10 ml of KOH solution, potassium hydroxide solution. And the mouth of the bottle is closed with a split cork. Select one of the leaf of a plant and that leaf is inserted into the bottle through a split cork. Half part of the leaf must be outside the bottle, half part of the leaf must be inside the bottle. The entire setup is kept in sunlight for some time, 2 to 3 hours. After 2 to 3 hours, separate this leaf from the plant, separate this leaf from the plant and test it for starch, test it for starch by using iodine solution, by using iodine solution. If we test the leaf for starch by using iodine solution, half part of the leaf present outside the body is turns into blue or black color. Blue or black color, it indicates the presence of starch. Indicates the presence of starch. The remaining half part of the leaf present inside the bottle, no change in color. No change in color. Means here, photosynthesis takes place in the part of leaf which is present outside the bottle. That's why it is turns into blue or black color. The remaining half part of the leaf present inside the bottle, no photosynthesis takes place. So, no change in the color. Here, why? The outside portion of the leaf only turns into blue or black color. Why not the leaf inside the bottle? The two parts of the leaves, outside and inside, that's all the factors equally, water, sunlight and chlorophyll. But the part of the leaf, carbon actually is not available to the part of leaf which is present inside the bottle, which is present inside the bottle. That's why no photosynthesis takes place and no starch is prepared. So, based on this experiment, we can easily say that carbon dioxide is essential for photosynthesis. Here, why we use the KOH solution, potassium hydroxide solution? If any carbon dioxide is present inside the bottle, the KOH solution, potassium hydroxide solution, absorbs the carbon dioxide remains inside the bottle, inside the bottle. So while we conducting this experiment, we have to follow some precautions. We have to follow some precautions. Let us discuss about the precautions. The precautions, first precaution is the part of the leaf present inside the bottle, the part of the leaf present inside the bottle should not touch the KOH solution. What is the first precaution? The part of the leaf present inside the bottle should not touch the KOH solution. Next, second one, the mouth of the bottle is should be kept airtight. The mouth of the bottle is should be kept airtight by applying grease or Vaseline. By applying grease or Vaseline. That is about this activity. Why are we conducting this activity? To prove that carbon dioxide is essential for photosynthesis. Photosynthesis. Okay. We are going to next topic. Up to several years, nobody knows about the energy for photosynthesis. Plants need some energy to perform photosynthesis and to produce oxygen. So, up to several years, nobody knows about the energy. energy, John Ingenhouse conducted experiments. And in 1779, John Ingenhouse. In 1779, he found that formation of oxygen during photosynthesis takes place only in the presence of light. To prove it, he conduct an experiment on water plants like by using hydrilla, elodia, like water plants. Okay, next, another scientist, Engelmann. He detected the point of maximum rate of photosynthesis. Who detected the point of maximum rate of photosynthesis? Engelmann. He conducting experiments on strains of algae and by using light sensitive bacteria. Why he used oxygen sensitive bacteria? More number of bacteria are accumulates at the site of between red and blue rays. Already we know, and if the light, white color light what we see is actually mixing of seven colors. When the white light is passes through a spectrum, for example, this is the white light. If it is passes through a spectrum, it is divides into seven colors. Seven colors. What are they? They are called as PIGR. P means violet, I means indigo, B means blue, G means green, I means yellow, O means orange, R means red. PIGR. In these all colors, the oxygen sensitive bacteria accumulates more between the blue and red rays. In green color, no photosynthesis takes place because plants reflect green color. So in green color, no photosynthesis takes place. The maximum point of photosynthesis present between the blue and red rays, that is 400 to 700 nanometers. This is the point of maximum rate of photosynthesis. Okay, up to 7 years, nobody knows about the energy. Means from where the plants gets energy to perform photosynthesis. Okay, to found that, who conducted the experiments? John Ingenhouse. In 1779, what he found? He found the formation of oxygen during photosynthesis takes place only in the presence of light by conducting experiments using water plants like hydrilla and elodia. Next, another scientist, Engelmann. What he detected? He detected the point of maximum rate of photosynthesis. What is the point of maximum rate of photosynthesis? 400 to 700 nanometers. In which area it is present? It is present between the area of blue and red rays. Blue and red rays.